Hi, it's the Love Dinosaur, and in this installment, I'd like to talk to you about creativity. Okay, so I'll give you a little bit of background about myself in this video. I realize I haven't explained what is the Love Dinosaur too much in my videos up till now. Well, the Love Dinosaur is a song I created in 2007 or so with the help of some of the students I was teaching at the time, mainly, you know, young kids. And so it, from there, it kind of, there was a creation of this sort of concept or idea of this force that is ancient, that is, can awaken on Earth at any time to help bring love and greater understanding and compassion and unity to the planet. And just the idea of dinosaur, you know, gives you this ancient concept. So Love Dinosaur is anything, any force that's basically eternal and or ancient, you could say, that brings greater unity to the planet. So, you know, in recognizing my divinity and in my eternal nature, I decided I want to leave talks for the prosperity of humanity. I know it sounds grandiose. It's okay. You know, I've been encouraged to dream big from my own mentors in life, and I think there's nothing wrong with it. I encourage you to dream big. So I want to leave these videos for the sake of my, you know, future family, my descendants, for the sake of me 10 years from now, to see where I was at this stage of my life, of my journey, and really for the sake of humanity, because I believe we all have gifts, and we all have experiences and learning and wisdom that we've acquired through our unique life journeys that the world could benefit from if we choose to share it. So I'm not saying you should share it if you don't want to, but I'm just saying it's an option that we can all share our journey and help others to learn and grow in the sharing, and we also learn and grow in the sharing. You know, imagine everybody shared their wisdom, shared their life experience, you know, in a healthy way, not in like telling people what to do, but just like in a sharing, like I just want to speak my experience, tell my story so that people can learn from it, the good and the bad. Imagine more people did that. I think that humanity can grow in a quantum leap, you know, because then we don't all have to make the same mistakes. You know, the more we share openly and honestly about our own life, we can help others avoid making certain mistakes. We could also help others to choose certain paths that maybe did work. You know, okay, well, I see this guy over here, he chose this path and it worked. Maybe it could work for me too. And this guy over here, you know, he made these mistakes, and I was about to make those mistakes too, so I could avoid making them. That type of thing. So that's why I make the Love Dinosaur videos, for the sake of the future, for the sake of humanity, mainly because I'm inspired right now to do it. I mean, there are things and times in my life I'm inspired to do something, and now is one of those times. So I don't want to fight it. I want to go with it. And it's a challenge. It's a challenge because not everyone's going to agree with what I say. And, you know, I'm a sensitive being too. As well as infinite being, I'm also a sensitive being. So, let's get onto the topic. Creativity. So the title of this video is Don't put a limit on your creativity. Don't put a limit on your creativity. Yes, I know some people say, you know, from a psychological perspective, that when you say don't, your mind only hears the word after don't, doesn't actually hear the do not part. So for example, if you say don't overeat, your mind only hears overeat. Or don't smoke, your mind hears smoke, and then you continue the bad behavior. I think to a certain degree that's semantics, because sometimes someone tells me, don't do this, and that inspires me. You know, especially if it's like, don't beat yourself up. You know, I really do hear, don't beat yourself up, so when I'm beating myself up and you know, giving myself a hard time because I'm not perfect, I remember the don't beat yourself up message, and I say, you know what, I really want to take it easy on myself. So, you know, I don't think putting it in the negative is necessarily a bad thing. Anyway, my creativity wants to create this video as don't put a limit on your creativity. I don't want to say, you know, abundant creativity, you know, be limitless creativity. That's not what I want to say. So I chose to say what my creativity wanted me to say, which is don't put a limit on your creativity. So what do I mean by that? Many times as creative beings, whether you make videos or art or music, or maybe you just make dinner for yourself at night, or, you know, if you drive trains, or, you know, make pottery or fix refrigerators, it doesn't matter. You have to make creative choices every day. You know, what time am I going to wear? How am I going to eat my food? Am I going to take a drink first and then eat? Or am I going to eat the things on the perimeter of the plate first and then eat the center? We all can make choices every day. So even if we're not creators in terms of like artists and whatnot, or artisans, it doesn't mean that we're not creators. Because we all are co-creators of this wonderful, beautiful world. Thank you, nature. I appreciate being here with you today. This is across the street from my house, by the way. Nobody would know it. I live in Brooklyn, New York. Yes, there are quite a few bugs, and I might get some ticks on my legs, which might turn off many, many people. I think that's nature's great way of protecting this place from getting too many unwanted visitors. Anyway, I'm taking advantage because this place has only a small window of really being this friendly. And then there's just, whatever, too many bugs and or it's just too cold. So when we want to be creative, it's usually because we were inspired by some other artist, some other person, someone's actions, someone's deeds. So let's say we see a video on YouTube and we say, oh man, I'd like to make a video like that because I was inspired by that video, so I want to make a similar video to inspire others. That's cool. And that's what I'm doing right now. There are a number of people on YouTube who really made inspirational videos, maybe in a similar vein to what I'm doing. So that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. Or it sparked the confidence in me that I can do it. What I want to mention, or the same thing, you know, when you're beginning to play music, you want to copy your favorite artists and make songs like them. I know I wanted to make songs that sound like Metallica and Iron Maiden when I first started playing guitar. But I never really could. They always kind of sounded different. So what I want to point out is a lot of times we try to copy the source of our inspiration. Let's say this guy made a video. Let's call him Billy. Billy made a video, and I want to copy Billy's video because it inspired me. But then what happens, if I do succeed in copying that, then I've created something that's not authentic. Or chances are I won't succeed at copying it. It'll come out quite different. And I might just kind of get frustrated that, man, it's not nothing like my inspiration's video, so I'm not actually even gonna go through with it. So we get stopped because we wanna be perfect, because we wanna be like somebody else. And that's where the message for today comes in. I think it's very important to just follow your bliss, thank you Joseph Campbell, follow your heart, follow your mission, and use what you have. That's another video I made, use what you have, if you want to check that out. And not only use what you have, but be creative with your limitations. So let's say, you know, I always love coloring pictures with 64 crayons, you know, or 32, whatever, but when I have only 8 crayon box, that's great too. I don't get, you know, upset that there's less options. I say, what can I do with only 8 colors? I remember when I took composition, music composition lessons in Brooklyn College when I was a college student studying music, one of my teachers like challenged me to write a song with only four notes, compose with only four notes, or like do a guitar solo with only one note, or even two notes. Might sound ridiculous, but if you create that those confines, or you only use 16 measures, like many limit the length of it in a precise way, by doing that, you force yourself to think in new ways. It's not like, oh, I want a guitar sound that sounds like Eddie Van Halen or Slash. It's like, okay, I got two notes and a keyboard in front of me, and I gotta make a song. And if I do them this way, or maybe I do this one a little longer, this one a little shorter, you know, you get creative with limitations. I only have 8 crayons? Okay. So I don't have green and light green and dark green, but I wanna do this great picture of nature. So what I could do is I could press a little lighter. Then I could press a little harder. Then I could press very hard to get a gradation. You know, so that's what I mean by not limiting your creativity. Don't let a lack of resources, lack of time, really stop you from making that creative work. Today's video, you know, I knew I wanted to make one, but I wasn't sure I was going to be able to make it happen. I didn't know all the things I wanted to say. Didn't know if I could find the location. I was worried about getting ticks on my legs. You know, we have to do food shopping. I have to watch the baby. Various things. Many obstacles are always going to pop up. I said, I'm not going to limit my creativity that it has to be perfect. If I see that window of opportunity, I'm going to seize it. It may happen today, it may not, and that's okay. So, you know, what I want to encourage you, you know, just by listening to this, you know, it's not important to remember any details. It's just a message. Don't limit your creativity. The less you limit your creativity, in other words, the less you give yourself excuses to not create, just because, you know, there's always 100 excuses. Well, I can't do it as good as my role models, so why even try? This guy's 10 times better than me, I'll never be that good. Why even try? Excuses. You have an authentic message, you have something that might be able to help people. And only you can help those people. Not your role model, because the people you're going to help don't even know about your role model. So who cares? The important thing is that your role model inspired you to want to create something. Take advantage of it. Just that inspiration is priceless. Pass it on. That's what I'm trying to do in this video. Pass on my inspiration. Pass on a little bit of wisdom I've gained in this lifetime to those of you who may be watching. I'm always looking for the wisdom of others to learn from, especially when it's given in a way that's really encouraging. Okay, so the more you just follow your authentic voice, and the less you worry about being perfect and copying others and trying to get it right, or trying to make it look as good as someone else's, or, you know, maybe your video camera's not great quality, it doesn't matter. In the beginning when I made videos, it was just all my phone, and the audio I didn't always get right, and, you know, I didn't know how lighting, and I just put them out there. Some of the videos people ignored, some of them have over 1,000 views. Yes, likes and dislikes, but I created something. There's something tangible for people to access all throughout the world. And that feels good. I'm not saying you have to do that, but I wanted to tell you that I didn't let that lack of resources or lack of knowing if I'm doing it right, lack of, you know, fear of like, okay, am I gonna get positive results from this? It was all I had, went through all that. I made them anyway, and I began to see the fruits. It's been a couple of years now, and you know, subscribers are growing slowly. That's fine. They are growing, you know. And I know there's always the possibility of quantum leaps. So sometimes in life, things go ahead slow, slow, slow and steady, and all of a sudden they jump. So I know that that's possible, and I want you to remember that that's possible too when you create. You can create like what you might regard as low quality content, and then all of a sudden you learn something. It's just the right timing. You get some new resources, boom, your quality jumps. But if you're not on that path creating, you're not going to get there. So please don't limit your creativity and think you have to do it right, think you have to do it perfect, think you need certain resources. You know, you can get super creative just with dinner. Maybe every night at dinner, get creative. You know, maybe, for example, sometimes I don't have time to create a video, to write a song, whatever. I just have time to post an old poem that I wrote and an old picture that I took. I posted a poem and a picture, and that is my creative contribution. And I do it because I like to create. I'm a creative person. Maybe you are too. How can you create something? How can you give to the world your gifts in a way that is unique and authentic and doable and repeatable? You know, so you can continue to create content and feel good about it, if that's what you want to do. And if, like I said, you're not in the business of creating content, if it's not in your heart and soul to post things like that, maybe it's in the way you choose which tie to wear every day. Just because, you know, the guy on GQ magazine wears the blue tie and you can't afford this blue fancy tie, you can afford some tie, or maybe you can just make a new statement and wear no tie and unbutton the top thing. I don't know. But use your creativity. You come up with something. I want to tell the story of this woman in Brazil. I lived in Brazil as a volunteer for 5 months, 2010, and it was in, you know, a village that you can consider in poverty, although their spirit was not impoverished, but their resources were very limited, no running water. You know, I knew the income of many families, and they're all struggling month to month, couldn't really afford many, you know, supplies for school and clothing and etc. But they had big smiles on their face, you know, pretty much every day. They played football, soccer, you know. So anyway, there's this one woman who was in this town, and she had 5 kids. She's still pretty young, and she may have wanted to, you know, like us volunteers, travel the world. She may have wanted to, you know, like, be on the cover of a magazine or be on TV. You know, people sort, you know, could access TV in the village. You know, she may have wanted to really expand her life, but she couldn't. She didn't have money, and, you know, didn't even have electricity in her home. They had to walk, I don't know, half a mile with a bucket to get water every single day with her daughters. But what she did, she found a way to be creative, and she collected plastic bags, both new and used ones, different colors, and she created these very cool, like, foot mats. You know, these like circular things with different colors, like rainbow colors, black, white, whatever color bag you could find, red and greens. And, you know, she would sell them in the town, or at least that was her vision. I'm not sure if she got to that point in 2010. But I know I bought a few. I gave some as souvenirs, and I still have mine. And it's beautiful. I love looking at it every day. So her creativity was not stifled by her lack of resources. I mean, really, right? Some people might not think that's good enough. Like, oh, I don't want to play with bags. But these bags became works of art, treasures. So, you know, what can you do in your life that will allow your creativity to flourish, even though you feel like you don't have all the right camera equipment or all the right resources? So lastly, I just want to leave you with this point, that when we just allow the inspiration in our lives to really inspire us, that's what it's there for. Not to copy. There's nothing wrong with copying. We learn from copying. But that's not the end point, because copying, you know, there are no two snowflakes that are the same, right? So there are no two people that are the same either, of course. So we all have an authentic, unique expression to give. And the universe benefits from authenticity, because we as beings who receive this authentic message feel relaxed. Ah, someone's being real. We feel encouraged. Oh, I could do that. They went through such and such struggles. They had such and such victories. That sounds like something I could do. I want to keep going. I want to inspire the next person. It works like that. So remember, the more authentic you are, the more natural you are, the more you use whatever resources you have, your time, your space, whatever it is, to get creative, the more the universe will appreciate it, the more happy you're gonna feel because you're letting the energy flow through you, and the more unstoppable you'll be because you won't allow excuses or lack of resources to stop you anymore. So maybe it's redundant, I'm saying the same thing over and over again, but I mean it. Please don't let your creativity, don't put a limit on your creativity. You can get creative. You can do it. And if you have some cool creative creations you want to share below in your comments, please do so. Have a fantastic, lovely day. This is a beautiful June day, June 6, 2016. Really fortunate to make it through here, hopefully without any tick bites. I'm going to go back, have a bite to eat with my family, and more videos to come soon. Stay inspired. See you next time.